Welcome to SATU Career 2.0 online nursing channel. This is AIIMS Nursing Officer Exam 2020 Super Challenge Question Series. This part 1 questions, 51 most important questions in various nursing officer exams. Please subscribe to our channel if you are not a subscriber yet. Also click the bell icon to get the latest notification about all new question and answer videos. Let's see the first question in this series. A patient who has just had a kidney transplant is transferred from the post-anesthesia care unit PACU to the intensive care unit ICU. How often should the nurse in the ICU should monitor the patient's urinary output? Option A, every hour. Option B, every 2 hour. Option C, every half an hour. Option D, every 15 minutes. So the nurse in the ICU should record the patient urinary output for every hourly. Option A is right. Question number 2. During which stage of healing does granulation and epithelialization occurs? Option A, the maturation phase. Option B, the epithelial closure phase. Option C, the inflammatory phase. Option D, the proliferative phase. The granulation and epithelialization occurs during option D, the proliferative phase. Question number 3. Which of the following factor provides a stimulus for the production of RBCs? Option A, decline of low vitamin B12. Option B, low HB and hematocrit level. Option C, tissue hypoxia. Option D, normal kidney function. The factor which is stimulating the production of RBC is option C, tissue hypoxia. Question number 4. Which is the most important for the nurse to do when providing a care to a patient who has had transurethral resection of the prostate gland? Option A, ensure the patency of indwelling catheter. Option B, maintain patency of the systemic tube. Option C, observe the wound for hemorrhage and infection. Option D, keep the abdominal dressing clean and dry. The right answer, let's see. The right answer is option A, ensure the patency of indwelling catheter. Question number 5. The patient is told by the physician that the size of the patient muscle has decreased. How should the nurse document this occurrence? Option A, dystrophy. Option B, atrophy. Option C, hypertrophy. And D, metastasis. Right answer, this is called atrophy. Question number 6. A 72-year-old patient is being discharged from same day of surgery after having a cataract removal from his right eye. Which discharge instruction should the nurse give to the patient? Option A, sleep on the operative side. Option B, resume all activities as earlier. Option C, wear an eye shield all days and remove it at night. Option D, do not rub or place pressure on the eyes. The right answer, in this case, the discharge instruction to be given is do not rub or place pressure on the operator eye. Question number 7. A patient receiving captopril during drug therapy for heart failure, the nurse should notify the physician that the medication therapy is ineffective if an assessment reveals option A, a skin rash. Option B, a peripheral edema. Option C, postural hypotension. Option D, dry cough. The assessment of peripheral edema is more concerned here. If it is present, then we can come to a conclusion, this captopril drug therapy is not effective. Question number 8. Which is a potential complication for central line placement? Option A, hemothorax. B, liver laceration. C, pneumothorax. D, spleen laceration, the potential complication for central line placement. The right answer is option C, pneumothorax. Question number 9. Which term describes softening of tissues by wetting or soaking? Option A, maceration. B, eschar. D, sloughing. D, angiogenesis. Softening of tissues by wetting or soaking is called option A, maceration. Question number 10. Crohn's disease can be described as chronic relapsing disease. Which are of the GI system may be involved in this disease? Option A, the entire length of the large colon. Option B, only the sigmoid area. Option C, the entire large colon through the layers of mucosa and submucosa. Option D, the small intestine and colon affecting the entire thickness of the bowel. So, which part of the GI system involved in Crohn's disease? Right answer, option D, the small intestine, specifically with colon affecting the entire thickness of the bowel, is the part affected in Crohn's disease. Question number 11. Anxiety elicits changes in the neurohormonal response involving which neurotransmitter implication? Option A, gamma aminobutyric acid. B, acetylcholine. C, epinephrine. D, 5-hydroxytryptophan or serotonin. The right answer, the neurohormonal implication in the anxiety is option A, gamma aminobutyric acid. Question number 12. Which type of anemia results from the deficiency of all of the blood elements caused by the failure of the bone marrow to generate enough new cells? Option A, sickle cell anemia. B, folic acid deficiency anemia. C, iron deficiency anemia. And D, aplastic anemia. So the type of anemia which occurs due to the bone marrow inability to generate all type of blood cell is called aplastic anemia. Option D, aplastic anemia. Question number 13. Which of the following acts committed by a nurse is an intentional tort? Option A, breach of confidentiality. Option B, battery. C, abandonment. Option D, negligence. The act committed by a nurse considered to be intentional tort is option B, battery. Question number 14. The purpose of the multidisciplinary team is to: option A, assist the nurse in performing a patient care. Option B, minimize the last shoots on CCU. Option C, provide holistic and comprehensive nursing care. Option D, replace the concept of primary care in acute care nursing setting. The purpose of multidisciplinary team. The right answer is to provide holistic and comprehensive nursing care. Question number 15. Which term is used for the spontaneous loss of pregnancy? Option A, abortion. B, missed abortion. C, miscarriage. D, missed pregnancy. The spontaneous loss of pregnancy is called option C, miscarriage. Question number 16. The response shown by the adult in the following picture is: option A, normal plantar response. B, extensor plantar response. Option C, ankle response. Option D, tau reflex. So, identify the response shown by the patient for the stimulus. The right answer it is option A, normal plantar response. Question number 17. Name this maneuver. Option A, Epley maneuver. B, Simont maneuver. Option C, Helmlich maneuver. Option D, abdominal thrust. The right answer, this maneuver is called Simont maneuver. Question number 18. Identify the drain. A. Penrose drain. C. True Close drain. C. Jackson Pratt drain. D. Reddywack drain. This drain is called Penrose drain. Option A. Penrose drain. Question number 19. Identify the fetal position shown below. Option A. Right occiput anterior. Option B. Left occiput anterior. C. Right occiput posterior. D. Left occiput posterior. The fetal position shown in this image is left occiput anterior. Question number 20. Name the device in the image. Option A. Color Doppler. Option B. Non-stress test. Option D. EMG. Option C. Portable TENS. The device in this image is option C. Portable TENS. Question number 21. A nurse in the labor room performing vaginal assessment on a pregnant client in labor and notes the presence of umbilical cord protruding from the uterus. What would be the initial nursing action? Option A. Gently push the cord into the vagina. Option B. Place the client in a Trendelenburg position. Option C. Perform vaginal examination to note the presentation. Option D. Notify the staff that the client will be transported immediately to the delivery room. So when there is umbilical cord protruding from the uterus, the initial action the nurse should take is to place the client in a Trendelenburg position. Question number 22. By looking at this picture, identify it. Option A. Laryngeal mask airway. Option B. Single lumen airway. Option C. Oxygen mask. Option D. Endotracheal tube. The image shown in this picture is option A. Laryngeal mask airway. Question number 23. Which of the following is not an antiemetic? Option A. Domperidone. Option B. Amiodarone. Option C. Ondansetron. Option D. Diphenylhydramine. The drug amiodarone is not an antiemetic. It stimulates vomiting. Question number 24. The doctor has ordered 500 ml 5% dextrose to be administered for 5 hours. It should be administered using a burette set. The nurse has to set the drops per minute to deliver the appropriate amount. Calculate the flow rate. Option A, 100 micro drops per minute. Option B, 100 macro drops per minute. Option C, 50 macro drops per minute. Option D, 50 micro drops per minute. Calculate the flow rate. The right answer, 100 micro drops per minute is right here. Question number 25. Name the diagnostic procedure usually done in OBG clinic. Option A, color Doppler. Option B, ECG. Option C, NST. And D, amniocentesis. The right answer is non-stress test. Question number 26. A woman using diaphragm for contraception should be instructed to leave it in place for at least how long after intercourse? Option A, 2 hours. Option B, 4 hours. Option C, 6 hours. Option D, 12 hours. So the diaphragm should be left in the place after intercourse for minimum 6 hours. Option C, 6 hours is right. Question number 27. In the emergency department, which is considered as the fifth vital sign? Option A, response to pain. B, motor response. C, verbal response. D, pupillary reaction to light. The fifth vital sign in the emergency department is pupillary reactions to light. Question number 28. A patient with a diagnosis of urosepsis has been admitted to the ward. You have been asked to start noradrenaline for hypotension. What is the normal route of administration? Option A, wide bore cannula in the posterior tibial vein. Option B, wide bore cannula in the brachial vein. Option C, peripheral cannula. D, central venous line in the subclavian vein. So the normal route of administration of noradrenaline in hypotension is option C, peripheral cannula. Question number 29. What position is given to a child with tetralogy of Fallot? Option A, supine. B, squatting. C, prone. D, side lying. The right answer, squatting position is normally given in the child with tetralogy of Fallot, so that the breathing difficulty, everything will be decreased. Question number 30. A patient receives continuous salbutamol nebulization therapy. The nurse should assess for option A, serum magnesium. B, serum sodium. C, serum calcium. Option D, serum potassium. Nebulization therapy in salbutamol, by using salbutamol, the potassium level should be regularly monitored. Question number 31. Which injection is given to enhance the expulsion of placenta? Option A, ergometrine. Option B, epidosin. C, xylokine. D, digoxin. For expulsion of placenta, the drug given is ergometrine. Question number 32. A purplish discoloration of the mucous membrane of the vagina that occur only in early stage of pregnancy is A, Goodell sign. B, Heger sign. C, Osiander sign. D, Jacumer sign. Purplish discoloration of the mucous membrane of the vagina is known as option D, Jacumer sign. Question number 33. Common causes of cephalopelvic disproportion or contracted pelvis includes all except option A, nutritional deficiency. B, a large size baby. D, brow presentation. C, androgen deficiency. So which of the cause is not included in cephalopelvic disproportion? Right answer, androgen excess will cause cephalopelvic disproportion. Androgen deficiency will not cause contracted pelvis or cephalopelvic disproportion. Question number 34. In which condition the umbilical cord is attached to the margins of placenta? Option A, battledore placenta. B, circumvallate placenta. Option C, placenta membranacea. Option D, velamentous placenta. The right answer, battledore placenta, in which the umbilical cord is attached to the margins of placenta. 35. The shape of human placenta is A, spherical. B, oval. C, discoid. D, fusiform. The right answer, oval shape. Question number 36. pH of normal semen is A, 7.2 to 7.8. B, 6.8 to 7.2. C, 7.6 to 8.2. D, 7.4 to 8.0. The normal pH in human semen is 7.2, 7.8 according to WHO. Question number 37. Frozen DPT vaccine should be option A, brought to room temperature before use. Option B, shaken thoroughly before use. C, discarded. D, allowed to melt before use. The right answer, option C, it should be discarded. Question number 38. Schedule for intradermal rabies vaccine is 0, 3, 7, 28 days. Option B, 4, 8, 16, 28 days. C, 0, 3, 9, 18 days. Option D, 0, 8, 24, 28 days. Intradermal rabies vaccine is given in the gap of the 0 day, 3rd day, 7th day and 28 days. Flatten P waves, widen QRS complex, depress ST segment, tall tender T waves are characteristics of A, hyponatremia, B, hypocalcemia, C, hyperkalemia, D, hypokalemia. The right answer, option C, hyperkalemia. Question number 40. Warm, dry and flushed skin is seen in which among the following? Option A, anaphylactic shock, B, neurogenic shock, C, hypovolemic shock, D, cardiogenic shock. The right answer is option B, neurogenic shock. Question number 41. Identify the following procedure. Option A, percutaneous transluminal coronary angioplasty. Option B, coronary artery bypass grafting. Option C, percutaneous transanginal coronary angiography. Option D, cardiac catheterization. This procedure is option A, percutaneous transluminal coronary angioplasty. Question number 42. Which ethical principle is promoting self-determination by clients? Option A, fidelity. B, beneficence. C, justice. D, autonomy. Self-determination is promoted by the ethical principle called option D, autonomy. Question number 43. Name the device in this image. Option A, goniometer. B, tonometer. Option C, Schecker's tape. Option D, perimeter. The right answer is option B, tonometer. Which among the following sign and symptom will be present in a patient with hypovolemia? Option A, edema. B, skin may feel taut and hard. Option C, urine output 10 to 30 ml per hour. Option D, crepitus or auscultation. In hypovolemia, option C, urine output will be 10 to 30 ml per hour. Now let's see question number 45. At 40 weeks of gestation, what is the normal volume of amniotic fluid to be present? Option A, 850 ml. B, 750 ml. Option C, 600 ml. Option D, 500 ml. The right answer, option C, 600 ml amniotic fluid should be present at full term. Question number 46, max division of the number 455 in the ratio of 4:3 will be option A, 190 and 160. Option B, 160 and 195. Option C, 320 and 260. Option D, 400 and 300. Let's see the answer. Answer, given ratio is 4:3. Sum of ratio is 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. The first number will be 4 by 7 into 455, which is 260. Second number, from the 455, you reduce 260, it gives 195. So the answer, 260 and 195. Question number 47. A 210 meter long train crosses a platform in 120 seconds. What is the speed of train? Option A, 2.5 meter per second. Option B, 3.5 meter per second. Option C, 10 meter per second. Option D, cannot be determined. Very simple. The answer, the speed of the train, the formula is length of the platform and train divided by time in crossing. So all the values are not available here. So we cannot determine the length of the platform. 48. The diameter of your circle is 7.7 centimeter. What is the circumference of the circle? Option A, 26.4 centimeter. Option B, 24.2 centimeter. Option C, 28.4 centimeter. Option D, 22.2 centimeter. What is the circumference of the circle? The right answer, 24.2 centimeter. The solution, circumference of the circle is equal to pi into diameter of the circle. So the value of pi is 22 by 7 into 7.7, which gives the circumference of the circle as 24.2 centimeter. Question number 49. Madhumita sells an article for ₹3,240 and earns a profit of 20%. What is the cost price of the article? Option A, 2800. Option B, 2750. Option C, 2820. Option D, 2700. The right answer is ₹2700. The cost price of the TV set is equal to 100 by 120 into 3240, which gives 2700. That is the right answer here. Question number 50. Who is the famous female personality in this image? Option A, Tammy Duckworth. Option B, Simon Billis. Option C, Malala Yousafzai. Option D, Hillary Clinton. So write down the answer in the comment section. So these are the 50 questions which we covered in the first video. In the second video, another 50 questions we will see. Totally 200 questions we are going to see in 4 parts. Don't miss any video. Wait for second video. Thanks for watching this video. If you like all these 4 videos, you can click and watch all these 4 videos. Please subscribe to Sathish R 2.0 online nursing channel and like this video and comment about this video. Meet you again with another good questions. Still there, take care. Bye bye. Thank you.